So in this tutorial, we're going to be talking about different types of plots that could be useful for data analysis. So the first type of plot, if you've ever used Excel or watched a PowerPoint presentation, you've probably seen this. You've probably seen most of these actually. So the bar plot. So suppose we have some sequence of data. Let's just say x equals 1 to 10. And we want to plot this on a bar chart. We just call the method bar, pass in x, and we see the bar chart. So this does pretty much the exact same thing as the plot function, except instead of connecting them all in a line, it connects, well, it doesn't connect the points at all. It gives them each their own individual bar. So just for reference, let's do our sine example again. Okay, so we're going to do bar xy, right? So this is a bar chart of the sine function. Okay, so the next type of plot that I want to talk about is the histogram. So if you've ever seen, if you ever studied probability, you know about probability distributions, and given a data set, we might want to figure out what kind of distribution does it follow. So let's generate some data where we know the distribution. So I'm going to create 1,000 points that are normally distributed. So if I plot this, it doesn't do much. It just looks like noise. So I won't be able to see much from that. What you want to do is you want to call a function called hist, which will automatically create a histogram out of your data. So I'm going to call the simplest version, which is hist of just the data. Right? And so you see that it's pretty much normally distributed. There's a little bit more weight on the right bar than the left bar in the center. And so the resolution for this chart is not that great. So what you can do is you can set the number of bins, right? So if you have a lot of data, in our case 1,000 points, you can set the bins to maybe say 50, okay? And so this gives us a much more granular representation of the data. So now we can see it still looks normal. You know, there's a little less data than expected, kind of right here at zero, and then a little more to the right of that. But generally speaking, this plot is pretty much what we'd expect. The next type of plot that I want to talk about, again, if you've used Excel, you've probably seen this, or PowerPoint, is a pie chart. So we're going to work with some simple data again. Let's say x is 1 to 5, and all I do is I call a function called pie, pass in the data, right? And so it automatically splits up the data. So the dark blue is the first element, light blue is the second element, green is the third element, and so on. And so there are ways that you can label this to make your visualization better. And so when you show it to people, they know what everything stands for. So there's a lot of documentation on the MATLAB website for that. The last type of plot that I want to talk about, probably the most useful for data analysis, is called the scatter plot. So we're going to again return to our sine example. So x is ln space from 0 to 2 pi. Let's give it 1,000 points. So now I'm going to do something a little different. I'm going to set it y equals 10 times sine x so that the sine x has an amplitude of 10. And then I'm going to add some random noise with variance 1 centered at 0. And so the reason why I want to scale it by 10 is so that the sine wave is big compared to the noise. Otherwise, the noise will just take over the shape of the sine wave. I did that wrong. Okay. So now if I were to just plot x and y, so you can see a noisy sine wave, which is okay. If I do it in a scatter plot, I can see that pattern pretty much just as well. So the nice thing about our sine x example was that the data was ordered. Now suppose that my data is not ordered. So instead of having ln space, my x is just a bunch of random points. So x is normally distributed with a standard deviation of 2. Okay, and so y is going to be, let's say, 5 times sine x plus some noise. Okay, so if I plot x and y now, I don't really see anything. It just looks like a bunch of craziness. But scattering, so a scatter plot, that will just plot all the dots, so all the individual data points, right? And so I can now very clearly see the sine wave that I'm supposed to see. So if you're doing data analysis, your points are not ordered, you want to use a scatter plot.